the creation. It was a long time ago, right enough. Thousands and thousands of years since. There was nothing where the earth is now, absolutely nothing at all. We'll know, God says to himself one day. I'll fix a wee bit of land in there. So, to start with, God ordered up some light to break out of all the darkness. He then made the skies and dry land, and gathered up the waters and the seas. He gave them all names. And when he made ado, two muckle orbs appeared, the sun and the moon, to give light to the earth both day and night. And a wee while later, God made thousands of bright stars to twinkle in the dark of the night. The man was fair pleased by it all. Now then, he says, well, here shall some life about the place. He gied out mere orders for the earth to burst forth with trees and bright wee flowers. He filled all the waters full of fish. He made birds to fly in the skies and sing sweetly among the trees. It was a brilliant world that God was stirring off, and he felt sure he was making a good job of it. However, no matter how good it was, the land still lay empty. So God made hundreds of different beasts, lions and tigers, giraffes and gazelles, grinning hyenas, dogs and frogs, big roaring bulls and huge hippopotami, and thousands of wee creeping creatures. God then made folk to look like himself, man and woman together. They'll hear hearts and minds to love me, God says. I'm going to put them in charge of this whole world to keep it in fine fettle. The Lord beamed with gladness at his work. By this time, it was the seventh day, and the Almighty was due for a wee rest.